Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarians on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. The new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, is a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. It is November 21, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday, and we will all cross the finish line together. First article of interest. A high-level delegation from the region visits Baghdad. November 21, 2019. Baghdad. A high-level delegation from the Kurdistan region will visit Baghdad and meet with Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi for the purpose of discussing the region's share of the 2020 budget. The representative of the regional government in Baghdad, Fares Issa, said that a high-level delegation from Kurdistan will visit Baghdad next week and meet with Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi and the ministers of finance and planning in the federal government, adding that the Kurdish delegation will discuss the region's share of the 2020 budget. The Kurdish delegation, according to the representative of the provincial government in Baghdad, each of the minister of the region, Khalid Shwani, finance minister Awad Sheikh Janab, and the president of the office of the presidency of the region Omid Sabah. Issa expected that the meeting next week will be the last between the parties because they have made important strides in the discussions on the 2020 budget and the region's share of the budget. Next article of interest. A deputy intends to investigate the auction of the currency and confirms the possession of the names of those involved. 0855, 21 November 2019. Baghdad. A member of the Parliamentary Integrity Committee High Nassif, on Thursday, the committee's move to open an investigation auction currency, indicating that there are a lot of personalities involved in this area, will be referred to the judicial authorities. Nassif said in a statement to the information that the Parliamentary Integrity Committee, especially after the completion of a law from where you get this, it is heading towards opening the currency auction in the central bank. She added that the chairman of the committee will form a team of members of the House of Representatives in order to open an investigation auction currency, in addition to the Office of Financial Supervision expressed cooperation with the Commission on Integrity and confirmed that there are files ready on the auction of currency. She pointed out that next Saturday will be the formation of the said team to investigate the auction of the currency and refer those involved to the judiciary, where there are indications of some people who did not have property before 2003, while you find owners of banks and large property, and therefore the law from where you will apply this on them. She stressed that the Commission on Parliamentary Integrity owns the names of banks and personalities involved in the corruption of currency auction, where there are many of them took advantage of the period after 2014 to increase its funds. Next article of interest. Parliament plans to annul and amend 11,000 decisions issued by the former regime. 10:39, 21 November 2019. Baghdad. The Parliamentary Economy and Investment Committee announced on Thursday that the House of Representatives intends to annul and amend 11,000 decisions issued by the deposed regime and hinder the process of development and advancement in the country at the judicial, political and economic levels. A member of the committee, Atwan Alatwani, said in a statement seen by him, the parliament seeks to review, amend or cancel 11,000 decisions issued by dissolved Revolutionary Command Council, which have hindered the advancement of judicial, political and economic institutions in particular, including the investment process over the past years. Parliament to take its role in making a breakthrough in investment activities in the country to serve the citizens in Baghdad and the provinces. Alatwani added, the Committee on Economy and Investment continues to urge the government to open up to the Arab, regional and global environment to attract capital and companies and provide jobs and stabilize the agreements that were signed a while ago with countries. The Iraqi laborer with remunerative salaries is equivalent to what the foreign worker earns in those companies, and that the numbers are more than the expatriates from abroad, except for the expertise needed by those companies. 2020 revealed the formation of a committee to review all decisions of the Council of Ministers on the mechanism of investment and activated and accelerate the implementation of those important and necessary projects and overcome the difficulties that hinder its work. Next article of interest. Deputy, Washington seeks to overthrow major heads in the political process. 21 November 2019 Iraq, Washington. The deputy of the Alliance of Saran Riyad Masoudi, Thursday, that the U.S. side seeks through the file to recover Iraq's smuggled funds to political blackmail of some personalities, and pressure on them to change the political approach in the country. Masoudi said in a statement to the information that the sanctions that America intends to impose on some Iraqi personalities aimed at overthrowing large heads in the political process, because the U.S. administration is seeking to pass a special approach to the management of the country. He added that the U.S. administration moves to recover the smuggled Iraqi funds, in addition to another file for politicians linked to money laundering and intelligence with other foreign countries, will use these files to pressure those figures to change the political approach. He said that America knows very well where the capital goes, but it uses these files for political blackmail, and therefore some politicians have caught themselves in the trap of American intelligence. So should be Iraqi national policy based on meeting the requirements of the people, without the search for narrow interests. Next article of interest. The document approved to simplify the lending procedures for the initiative of the central bank. November 21, 2019 Baghdad. The Prime Minister's Office, on Thursday, the approval of the President of the Council on the recommendations of the Board of Advisors on the simplification of lending procedures for the initiative of the Central Bank. According to the document issued by the office, got Euphrates News, a copy of which, attributed to your banks and under the supervision of the Central Bank of Iraq to lend investors and businessmen to the new small and medium enterprises and the reoperation and rehabilitation of projects and factories that require the opening of external and internal credits and the adoption of the following principles in loans. Next article of interest. Fed Chair Jerome Powell, U.S. looking into digital currency. November 20th, UP. The U.S. Federal Reserve is eyeing development of its own digital currency, Chairman Jerome Powell has said in a letter to federal lawmakers. In the letter, addressed to Representative French Hill, Republican Arkansas, and Representative Bill Foster, Democrat Ill, Powell said a central bank digital currency, or CBDC, is not yet ready to roll out, but members of the central bank are looking in that direction. We have assessed and continue to carefully analyze the costs and benefits of pursuing such an initiative, he wrote in the letter, dated Tuesday. Powell's letter was a response to a proposal last month from Hill and Forster for a government-backed cryptocurrency. Unlike Bitcoin, any proposed government digital currency would be backed by the Federal Reserve and would represent an unprecedented action in the global economy. Available to households and businesses, it would raise legal and operational issues but is possible well suited to a large economy like the United States, experts say. We are carefully monitoring the activities of other central banks to identify potential benefits that may be relevant in the U.S. context, Powell added. To date, our observation is that many of the challenges they hope to address do not apply to the U.S. The idea for a digital dollar has been floated for months since Facebook announced plans earlier this year for its Libra cryptocurrency, particularly over fears of a private, decentralized currency system outside government control. Next article of interest. Economists: the biggest corruption exists in the central bank and currency auction. November 21, 2019 Baghdad. Economists expressed their opinion on the actions of the Iraqi Integrity Commission on fighting corruption and corrupt in the Iraqi state, indicating that it dropped the secondary figures and left the big, stressing that the largest corruption exists in the central bank and auction currency. The Iraqi economic expert, Majid al-Suri, in a press statement followed by the Independent, on Wednesday, the corruption files that have been raised are just simple issues in the large corruption files that concern projects in most state institutions. He added, To go back to the reports of the Audit Bureau since 2005 and so far, there is a fixation of very large cases of corruption, especially with regard to the file of electricity and defense deals and the entry of ISIS, and these very large files of corruption shaking thrones, but unfortunately not addressed, because senior officials are involved and cannot condemn themselves. He pointed out that one of the main causes of corruption is the lack of real institutions in the Iraqi state, as evidenced by the contradiction between the ministries and their decisions, as well as the lack of application of laws, including the law on financial management and public debt, which has not been applied since 2003 and so far. For his part, said professor of economics at the University of Waseda Ahmed Al-Atwani, the pursuit of the figures involved in corruption is much more important than the follow-up of corruption sites to catch young corrupt, pointing out that, quote, has made the fight against corruption difficult. He added, the largest corruption exists in the central bank and auction currency, but those files are difficult to disclose because the corrupt have wide ways to circumvent in this framework. He pointed out that the size of corruption is estimated at $183 billion, but the failure to follow up on these files due to structural imbalance in anti-corruption bodies. The professor of political science at the University of Baghdad, Athir Al-Jasser, in a statement, the presentation of these files at the moment cannot be read only in the context of absorbing public anger, and cannot be taken seriously. If the Palestinian Authority wanted to succeed in absorbing the anger, it would have toppled the big political figures and the president involved in corruption cases. He pointed out that there is no longer any confidence between the Iraqi street and governments, and put corruption files in any formula will not only push Iraqis to question what is hidden from those files, pointing out that the most important question now is who is held accountable. There is a state of distrust of the entire political class. There is no confidence in its seriousness and the anti-corruption process. Next article of interest. Parliamentary bloc. The solution to the current crisis only with the resignation of the government of Abdul Mahdi. 21 November, 2019. Confirmed the Parliamentary Bloc of Goodness, Thursday, that the current crisis cannot be solved only by the resignation of the government of Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi. The head of the bloc, MP Mohammed Al-Khalidi, said that the political blocs are trying to circumvent the directives and speeches of Najaf reference, stressing, there is no solution to the current crisis only with the resignation of the government of Abdul Mahdi, especially after the bloodshed in the streets. Khalidi added that the agreement that came out of the house of the leader of the Movement of Wisdom Amr al-Hakim did not provide anything tangible for the street or even for the reference, which did not stop escalation after the agreement, but will continue to escalate its tone against the government and political forces supporting it. He stressed, the Iraqi street announced its clear and public rejection of this agreement, while the reference depends on its position, and therefore it will go to escalation in the coming days, because the agreement does not convince any sane. Next article of interest. Baghdad and Washington discuss the development of the Iraqi Air Force. 21 November, 2019. Baghdad, Washington. Air Force Commander Lieutenant General Anwar Hamid Amin discussed with U.S. Air Force Secretary Barbara Barrett and U.S. Air Force Commander David Goldfein Thursday logistical support in training, arming, and ways to develop the Iraqi Air Force. The Air Force Command said in a statement received by Al Sumeria News that Air Force Commander Lieutenant General Anwar Hamid Amin received U.S. Secretary of the Air Force Barbara Barrett and U.S. Air Force Commander David Goldfein and her delegation. The statement added that the two sides discussed several important issues concerning the two sides, including logistical support in the field of training and armament, and discussed ways to develop the Iraqi Air Force and strengthen the bonds of friendship between the two friendly countries. Be sure to like, subscribe and check out the new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. Tell them that Anarian sent you. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.